So I don't know if there's any balance to be found in this next story, but it's a really fascinating one. So Susan Sarandon, fabulous actress, everybody knows her, loves her. She's now saying that in a recent interview, she actually prefers dating younger, in some cases, much younger men, because she says, in her opinion, they are still curious when they're younger. Whoever, ladies, anybody want to jump into this one?
Well, can I just state the obvious here is that if our girl Susie was a dude, nobody would even be talking about this because we totally normalize older men having relationships
legit
with younger women.
Good point.
And, you know, if I was an older guy, I may take offense to what, you know, Susan Sarandon had to say. But on balance, I mean, aren't younger generations generally a little bit more curious and perhaps a little bit more, you know, socially progressive? I know that, for example, all those Gen Zs out there are making fun of my side part right now as a millennial and are dragging me, and, you know, rightfully so. But they also don't accept the same sort of heteronormative BS that was, like, pushed down my generation's throat. And I think that's progress.
Yeah. Can I jump in on this? Because I agree with a lot of what you're saying. First of all, this you know, Gen Xers also owning the side part. So I'm right there with you, sister. But I was thinking about this because, first of all, Susan Sarandon, you know, live your best life. You do you, whatever you want to do about this. But I was thinking, even though, like, frankly, I don't necessarily agree, and I find younger men a little bit, you know, more intimidated by strong women and that sort of thing. I think from her perspective, from her generation in particular, when you're dealing with baby boomer men, no offense out there, baby boomer men, but, you know, as you just said, Supriya, the issue of, you know, the sort of heteronormative gender dynamics, totally different now. And I think that a younger man could really, you know, bring something to the table for Susan Sarandon. So I get her perspective, even though it's not for me.
Jess Allen,
I don't want to put you on the spot, but you're, you know, your man, a little younger than you.
Well,
by how much?
My partner, Simon, is 9 years younger than me. And you guys, I've just realized that maybe I have a center part so that I can look like a millennial, like I can look like his age. But I have to say, I don't think all younger people are necessarily by default more curious, but coincidentally, what attracted me to Simon initially was the fact that he was so curious. The first time I met him, he was carrying a Toronto Public Library canvas bag, and it was filled with DVDs and books I'd never heard of. And I almost felt like a vampire, like sucking up his knowledge and being invigorated by being exposed to new things. But here's the truth. Sometimes now it can be exhausting. Like, do we really have to learn right now? I just want to watch Titanic, not like a Hungarian film from the 60s that might change my life, you know? Just give me Jack and Rose.
Just give me Jack and Rose.
Yes.
I do actually believe that we do perhaps, I don't know if we start to lose curiosity as we get older, but it certainly feels like we're less willing to act on it. Mm. I think that we become slowly but surely risk averse as we get older for many reasons. It could be physically, like maybe I don't want to jump out of a plane when I'm, you know, 87, but maybe I would have when I was 27. So there's like the physical part of it. But there is seemingly like once we start to get in our well-worn paths of what culture and society expects of us, so you get the job, you get the career, you get the kids, you get the picket fence, and it just seems like, okay, so you're done now. Like you kind of stop, you hit 40 and you're done. And so I think that, you know, Ryan is only 4 years younger than me, but only recently, but he's kind of like the old soul in our marriage because, you know, he's Italian and he works hard, comes home, provides for his family, and he's a happy guy. And recently he decided, because I'm bilingual, he's going to start learning French and for his daughter who's going to French school. And I was like, that's kind of hot.
Yeah,
so I think Susan might be onto something.
Very.
I think he's onto something.